So with the current big advancements that are coming, have you wondered what is going to happen with the QA? Or even, are you afraid of losing your job, you know, with AI and ChatGPT? Okay, let me try to see. Does this work? Yeah, cool. So yeah, I'm Rafaela. I have joined EE in 2018. And I have this blog, isvidrafaela.com, that I share my learnings since 2011. I have 16 years of experience in QA and test automation now. And yeah, we are gonna talk about quickly about, you know, QA role, journey, and the future. So the QA industry is constantly changing and evolving like any other position nowadays. It's natural path for any segment, industry, and role. So we need to check, you know, what is going on, the trends are the trends, and keep up to date every time is possible. We used to have only manual tasks. It was quite robotic and tedious tasks following scripts only. And also there was a lot of blaming game. Todd, your GIF was much better than mine. I love it. So yeah, we used to break things and there was a lot of devs versus QA's mindset. And the current QA position now is more dynamic. So we do automated tests. We need to know, you know, business logic, infrastructure as well, programming, of course. Companies, they hire QA to be more like an advocate nowadays and specialist, so they can help the whole team with this quality role. Embracing multiple layers as well. So as I said, for infrastructure, front-end, database, back-end, cloud usability. We kind of embrace a lot of things nowadays. It's really complex and we need to keep everything in mind. It's crazy about it. But yeah, we still need to keep in mind the business and logic as well, on top of all the technical part. So basically we are expected to be a full stack QA, as I say nowadays. It is overwhelming to think about all the things that can break in the ecosystem. Even like the part of layout, we can have a look and usability, and we can give our updates and everything that we think that we can improve. And okay, but then what is coming next if the layout, if the slide also goes left? Yes, okay, cool. So this is not really new, to be honest. Observability and security tests, we have this nowadays, but with AI advancement, we are releasing some of the technical part and we can have more time to think about other things that were already there, but nobody really paid that much attention. Maybe on the financial companies, to be honest. AI tests, of course. Nowadays, AI can create functions, classes, and in any languages. It still needs human to review, to be honest. You can have a look on GitHub Copilot. It's paid at the moment, but I tried the trial version and it was really good. And of course, you probably are tired to hear it, but not tired to use ChatGPT, that you can do a lot of things, even sending nice and friendly messages to your mom, like I did in the past, when she's like going crazy. And yeah, so everything related to AI, like data engineering, data science, will be used to potentialize our role and most of the jobs anyway. This guy, Jason Arbon, is a person who talks a lot about, you know, AI tests. And in case you want to know more, his is his Twitter. Cloud tests are also a hot topic. I know that many people are already using. I have used it in the past, but not much. You'll be able to scale your tests easily, and you don't need to worry about infrastructure that much. Web3 tests, metaverse, blockchain, and NFTs. This is already there as well, but it's quite small. And because AI is coming, people are more concerned about privacy. So this is definitely coming, even though it's small. And Web3 is coming to protect your data, which is being used by the AI models to transform people in products. I like AI, even though it doesn't look like it, because I'm saying that. But I know that really improves my daily routine. This is a community, a Web3 test community, if you want to join. This is the link as well. And also soft skills. This is something that came up during the pandemic. And, you are all online all the time. And we need to improve our communication online as well, and talking like through video calls. And this is quite hard, especially people that were not used to working remotely, like creating the bonding and the connection. Even the CEO of LinkedIn has pointed out some years ago, strategy and critical thinking will be even more in demand as well. And yes, that's it. If you want to connect, this is my social media. Yes.